Hello.
Hello, hello, can you hear me?
يا دكتور، مساء حضرتك.
كيف حالك؟
الحمد لله يا دكتور، ازي حضرتك؟
والله بخير.
انا سعيد ان حضرتك وافقت ان نعمل لقاء مع حضرتك، ومتشرف شرف
Can you hear
كبير
me
ليا.
well?
يا دكتور، الو
Hello.
يا دكتور شوان، الو.
Hey, can you hear me?
ايوه دكتور، انا سامع حضرتك.
Yeah, can you hear me? I'm with you.
ايوه انا سامع حضرتك دكتور.
والله بخير، كيف حالكم؟
تمام الحمد لله دكتور، ازي حضرتك؟
والله بخير، كيف الأمورات في قطر؟
الحمد لله زي الفل، كله تمام يا دكتور، كله تمام
الحمد لله
الحمد
الحمد
لله.
لله.
حضرتك قطر قريب؟
والله شوف، I'm not quite sure. Things are a little bit busy at the moment, but we could yeah, I might come before the holidays here.
ان شاء
انت
الله
كيف
دكتور.
حالك؟
تمام،
ان
كله
شاء
تمام
الله
يا دكتور، الحمد لله
ان شاء الله.
ان شاء الله. كان عندنا بس شوية استفسارات، فكنا عايزين نرجع لحضرتك فيها بإذن الله.
ان شاء الله.
هو حضرتك زي ما اتعلمنا من حضرتك ان البيم المفروض اتطبق او بقى اجباري في بريطانيا في ابريل 2016، فهل هو فعلا تم تطبيقه بنجاح والشركات بقت شغالة بيه، ولا في مشاكل؟
والله بالحقيقة الماندات has been extended, the date been extended.
تمام.
الماندات for applying has been extended. But remember the mandate is for very big projects, which is sort of 50 million pound plus, which is mainly government projects. So it is companies are in the process of getting the credit accreditation for the different passes that has been produced, and probably this is what we call a BIM accredited company that will be able then to take on projects.
Tamam.
In the size that I've mentioned, so it's still not really applied as a mandate, but there are a number of companies, including small companies, embracing the processes and embracing the technology now, and they hope that this is going to be saving money and time in terms of the data flow and data management.
طب هل حضرتك مع تطبيقه وان هو يبقى اجباري في الدول العربيه زي قطر والامارات والعراق؟
Well, the issue of having it to be applied as a proper BIM processes is still a distance. It's just because of processes.
تمام، يعني قريب مش هيكون اجباري في قطر، او بقيت هو لغايه دلوقتي اجباري في دبي بس.
حتى في even في دبي الايشوز still exist in terms of the contract strategies that has been used. Issues still in terms of the culture in which information is transferred, in which the trust in which information is being shared. So it's still a long way to go to embrace the what's really a BIM, proper BIM implementation strategy.
تمام. طيب ايه اكتر فايده البيم ممكن قدمها لنا ما كانتش موجوده قبل كده؟
Well, I think the most thing that we see here, if we talk about the design, it's the ability to pull design fairly quickly using different libraries, and then changes can happen fairly quickly. So it's design authoring is getting lots of attention at the moment in terms of getting to use the technology and the processes, particularly the common data environment. Yet to see things happening in the downstream operations or downstream processes like construction, procurement, and probably integration of BIM with the supply chain and integration of BIM with the manufacturing processes. You know, that's the sort of thing that need to be embraced as well as the design process.
تمام يا دكتور. طيب لو احنا بنتكلم على اعاده التعمير وخصوصا في البلاد العربيه زي سوريا والعراق واليمن, ازاي البيم ممكن يفيدنا في النقطه ديت في اعاده التعمير؟
Well, it's if you look at the massacre has been created in different countries, so really it is about to pull an outline design fairly quickly through maybe different scanning of current buildings that needs to be repaired, or if buildings needs to be demolished, that's fine, needs to be demolished, but buildings that needs to be repaired, you can pull and build as is model using the technology, and then embed some of these 3D models, and that they can then speed up the design and procurement processes. The other thing in which the digital technology can help us really is the priority. You build a massive urban plan, a massive urban schedule for buildings to be maintained and or to be remodeled or to be and that is where digital technology can help, and can share it across the funders, particularly now there is a need for funding, need the funders, need the so technology can help in this, and then rapid design, because we need really massive of speed to rapid design, so you can the credibility in people and trust in them.
بإذن الله دكتور. طب بالنسبة للوضع الحالي للمشاريع في الدول العربية عامل إزاي, وإيه أكبر مشاريع استخدموا فيها البيم؟
Well, as far as I know, through our work in Qatar, there is the Doha Museum used digital project and embraced the supply chain to communicate in digital fashion with the rest of the consortia. You can see I'm sort of really refraining to use the word BIM all the time, because really what we saw is just the application of some sort of software, digital technology, in which impose certain processes on the supply chain. So basically I'm hoping that these lessons and these ideas that are generated then can be shared across the board. The only cases that I saw that been using properly some form of standard is through the Qatar Rail, which is a deployed consultant to develop protocols, develop processes, develop LODs, LOIs, etc. So this needs to be shared a little bit further, so therefore you can get back the investment to the country on these systems.
تمام دكتور. طب بعد اذن حضرتك يا دكتور, حضرتك شايف مين اللي بيقود البيم في الدول العربيه, الحكومات ولا شركات البرمجيات السوفت وير ولا شركات المقاولات ولا الاستشارات؟
والله I think the consulting engineers who are embracing this at the moment, I don't think contractors are, particularly the local contractors. When I say local contractors, I don't mean small contractors. Local contractors, those who operate in the Arab world like Laden and others, I think the BIM concept or the BIM drive is coming from the consultant, getting the client to believe that this is the world is moving into this, and therefore the big clients start to embrace this. So probably the consultant and coming on board these IT consultants, who they are getting some value or getting some contracts out of this. But really, the future is needed to be the construction industry board or the mandating of higher in some sort of government bodies
that is needs to manage the implementation or manage the accreditation processes, and that's the way forward. So it's not something imposed on somebody else. It's just a collaborative agreement that needs to be developed between different countries.
MashaAllah. طب حضرتك يعني ما شاء الله نشرت اكتر من 180 بحث واشرفت على رسائل كتيره جدا. دلوقتي في ناس كتيره بتعمل ماستر او بتعمل دكتوراه وعايزين يعرفوا ايه المواضيع اللي ممكن يكتبوا فيها وايه الامكانيه ان هم يتابعوا مع حضرتك في الجامعه يدرسوا مع حضرتك في الجامعه. اتفضل.
Yeah, نعم شكرا. Now I think the future research in building information modeling or in the, it's basically the inclusion of all what we call the four BIM level 4 or BIM level 5 or BIM level 6, in which we have a more comprehensive analysis of the buildings as they've been built. In any aspect, in terms of cost, time, comfortability, supply chain, influence on the environment, influence on the urban development. So that's something we started to develop and embrace in different research projects, particularly looking at the Internet of Things and looking at data capturing and the integration processes. So the idea is to have a lean, what I call a lean project or a lean urban information system that will encompasses all these sort of different technologies and different way sort of different way of working. So this is the future scenarios as the technology is being developed and as people started to be more acquainted and more happy to use it, more comfortable using the technology. So really the sky is the limit in terms of what you could do in terms of from the very outset of the design and development process and down to the way in which the building has been running, the way in which it's been monitored, then probably change of use. So all these needs to be digitally assessed, digitally available, within obviously a well-defined processes.
ما شاء الله. طب وإيه الجامعات اللي حضرتك بتدرس فيها دلوقتي؟
Well, at the moment I'm here as associate dean at Teesside University, looking not just at across the board in terms of research and design, not only construction design, but product and design in general, science and engineering. So that's across the board in terms of my unit managing people in this area. But basically, I do work in overseas universities, like in Japan and in Qatar, in Doha, in Saudi Arabia, and in a different collaboration, both in terms of exchange of knowledge and understanding of the research topic.
MashaAllah. طب حضرتك كنت عملت بحث مهم جدا عن الحمض النووي للبيم او الدي ان ايه، ممكن حضرتك تديني نبذه عنه؟
Yeah, what we I think what's all about in terms of the BIM, it's you know the BIM as we trying to simplify to people when I talk about it and just saying, well, it is Project DNA, it is, you need to think about everything at the very outset, and therefore you can build upon the information rather than you keep repeating the information or you keep repeating inputting and modeling the information. So the idea is really to have some form of concept that will incorporate all the, you know, like the DNA, all the ideas, all the what is going to be in the project to be encoded,
And therefore, when you go on and start to develop the product a bit further, so you can unwrap all of these issues. So you can, we're thinking about, obviously, the LODs, if we're thinking about different costing ways in terms of the project. We're thinking about the unit classes that needs to be incorporated in the very outset. So basically encompassing both of these ideas, so therefore it can be incorporated in the project. In fact, it's similar to the way that human, when you're born complete and then you grow. But that's the idea, because everything is there. All your maps, your is there in the DNA. So basically the idea is to attract people saying, okay, we need, when the project born and started, it will born with all the concepts, with all the ideas embedded. So therefore, when time goes by, things can be unraveled and unwrapped in a more fashionable way that will add value to the project, that, rather than constraining the constraints that have been produced on the project. And partly some of the issues that we have now in the projects is not just construction of oil and gas, not just in Qatar, not just in Saudi, not just in Iraq, not just in the UK, it's all over. It is the issues with the delays and the issues with the issues that comes once the construction started, just because we're really creating things as time is progressing, which conflicting with other information or with other user needs, and that is where the problems occur, and therefore this is where projects are getting delayed, lots of conflicts in terms of not just only design clashes and conflict, it's a process conflict. Supply chain is not in order in a way that information is being received properly, and that goes on and on and on, I'm afraid.
MashaAllah, doctor. طب بخصوص قطر, يعني اعتقد ان اكبر مشروع اللي هو الاستادات, ايه اللي تم فيها لغايه دلوقتي؟ الناس كتير عماله تسال وصلوا لفين, هل هيلحقوا يخلصوا؟
سوري,
الاستادات بتاعه الكوره بتاعه فيفا 2022.
I'm not really that much aware of you know, what is the current situation, but I think what I saw, what I read, and what friends tells me that things are going well, and things are started or in the process of being developed in different places in Qatar. I think the Wakra has been started construction, and you know, things are going, my understanding, everything is going well and as planned.
ما شاء الله. طب حضرتك كنت عملت ست مؤتمرات اللي هي تطبيقات البناء الواقع الافتراضي, ايه وصلت لحد فين, او ايه اللي ممكن يفيد في مجال البيم, الواقع الافتراضي مع البيم؟
I think since 2000 I started this particular conference, which is called Construction Application of VR. So we've done 16 events so far around the world, and the next one will be in New Zealand in November 2018. Now, basically, I started this to build a community of interest in the visualization technologies. At that time, in 2000, it was sort of a very new technology used in the game engine and the games industry, but not in construction. So we tried, the objective was to develop a community around this particular subject area. And alhamdulillah, there were some lots of successes, and this is the 17th conference going to be held at this in 2018. Now, how this is interacting with them, in fact, this is started to look part and parcel of the BIM world, as the BIM is the hub for information, of information that can be integrated and can be processed and can be
So the resulting technology will be a part and parcel of verification, validation of the information that is to be used. And it's whether it's geometrical information, which you can see buildings and you can walk through this. And now then in about 5-6 years ago, we started to look at the augmented reality and more use on construction side in terms of health and safety, training, etc., etc. And really, it's coming now into a way that the industry then can benefit or you can improve the cost effectiveness of these tools on site now through different research projects in different ways of looking at this. But really, the core of this is the information integration that we all endeavor to achieve in BIM, in particularly BIM level 3 and BIM level 4, where all the information there, so therefore you can explore it, you can analyze, you can experiment, and these technologies are really very exciting technology to be used.
ما شاء الله. امتى المملكة المتحدة وبريطانيا هتبدأ تطبق المستوى ليفل 3 او تبدا تشتغل بيه او تخليه اجباري؟
Well, this is a long term ambition, but it's interesting that at least keep the research institutions and the developers thinking about this particular new research areas in terms of integration of all models, and so you have a single model. Now, having said that, this might be achievable, might be in the technology. However, it's a little bit far away from the contractual and the risk assessment of the information flow. So it is a little bit far away from becoming a industry. Sort of industry use, it would take a few years to experiment with different contractual arrangements, even with the structure of the construction industry. Now, if you look at the car industry, for example, now that has been done. If you look at the Nissan, Toyota, the aerospace industry, you've got one single model, and the supply chain will feed to this model and try to work with this model. But we're talking about mega companies that manage the processes, like Nissan or like Toyota. Do we have a contractor like Nissan now, in terms of the volume, in terms of the ability to take risks? Now, this if the industry will change, restructure in the coming 5-6 years, yes, we will see lots of interesting work going on in the single model and level 3. And level 4 will start to look to be a reality. But as I said, Omar, it's still a little bit ambition. But it's exciting that at least we have something to think about and something that we can feed into our young researchers.
Inshallah, Doctor. طيب بعدين حضرتك يا دكتور دلوقتي ايه هي اكثر المشاكل اللي ممكن تواجه مدير المشروع عند الشغل بالبيم؟ يعني البيم هيحل مشاكل كتيره، هل ممكن تظهر مشاكل لمدير المشروع لو اشتغل بالبيم؟
Well, it's the problems is obviously misuse as anything else. If you misuse the technology, misuse the processes, of course that will create lots of havoc and the problems. Particularly, there are issues. Obviously, there are issues looking at the human side and skills available in people, you'll be able to manage and understand the whole BIM processes, particularly different passes. This is why we're trying to educate. There's lots of courses and lots of companies, particularly, for example, BRE and other companies that are getting accreditation of people on board.
طب ايه هو المعيار اللي خلينا اقول ان المشروع اللي قدامي ده مشروع بيم؟ يعني ممكن واحد يكون عامله عليه سوفت وير، فانا عايز ايه المعايير اللي ممكن احكم احكم ان ده فعلا معمول بيم مظبوط ولا لا؟
Well, المعايير the criteria being used to credit companies at the moment is basically a number of strands. The important one is obviously how you're using the PASS 1192. What processes you have on the ground to use PASS 1192 in terms of the information flow, in terms of the BIM execution plan, in terms of the all the data that needed to be developed as you go through the different project phases. You've got to prove that. The other big thing is the common data environment. You have a suitable and sustainable common data environment, and how common the environment work and operate, and whether you have the skills of people that we are able to manage the common data environment. And plus, you need to prove that your people have certain certificate in terms of some of these standards and some of these passes. And I think at the moment we have the like of in the UK a number of companies, including DRE, that might be able to come in and audit your equipment, audit your processes, and we'll be able to give you some sort of a level of compliance. And this particular level of compliance then will be used by the client to make sure that you are on board with the BIM journey. So that's the sort of thing that people will be looking to see. I know that the charter surveyors, Royal Charter Surveyors, are operating in the Gulf to give some presentation to them. I think they've been visiting Qatar and UAE to see whether that can be done. I think it for the Gulf is still early stages, particularly if you wanted to credit, because you don't only credit companies, but you credit the people as well.
تمام دكتور. طب ايه هي المشاكل الكولابريشن او تبادل المعلومات بالذات لما يكون البيم شغال مع جي اي اس في مشاريع الطرق او الريل؟ هل في مشاكل بتظهر؟
والله I don't have that much experience in using GIS in road in linear projects, but I think some of the issues are it's incompatible. Some of these Revit files, for example, being used with the way, for example, in which some of the systems that's going to be used in terms of GIS, for example. So still there is a work that's going to be done on the city GML, which is basically standard that will integrate all the assets on an urban scale. So still there's lots of work to be done on the standard. The problem, once they reach a particular point in the standard, then the software industry will move on. You know, that is the sort of issue that we have now. It's a catch-up.
تمام دكتور. طيب حضرتك شايف ايه هي الحاجة اللي هتبقى مايلستون او معلم كبير في البيم في المستقبل؟ يعني الحاجة اللي احنا نبدأ نركز عليها بحيث ان احنا نبقى حطينا رجلنا على طريق البيم في المستقبل.
I think probably a number of things that needs to happen. This is what we're doing here in the UK. It's not only to enable these very big companies, but the supply chain. If the supply chain is trained well and incorporated in the journey, things will work a lot better. Because as you know, not much of these big contractors would do work, particularly around the world. They're mostly depending on supply chain that will collaborate, and particularly small medium contractors that come on board and do the work. So basically this enabled, that's an important part of the construction industry, that this is what they've done in the manufacturing sector, which they enabled these
supply chain to collaborate and to come on board. So that's this is one thing. So that means probably a new generation of software. At the moment, we are very much dependent on the lack of Autodesk and other companies, but it needs a little bit more cheaper, thinner collaborative software that will be able to embrace this particular change. And I think things are happening in terms of the open source and other things that's happening. So probably these issues are quite crucial to get people to be engaged and to come on the problem journey.
تمام يا دكتور. طب حضرتك كنت كاتب بحث عن البيم مع الاستدامه والمدن المستدامه. ازاي البيم ممكن استفاد منه في تطبيق السستينابيلتي؟
Well, we've had a number of research projects looking at looking predominantly at using the outline processes, outline design processes. And sort of beefed up or augmented with IT tools that will be able to predict and forecast the issues related with the probably building energy consumption, strategies for reducing energy, the use of different material sources, what we call here carbon footprint. We've got something called the Green Book, which is specifying some carbon footprint calculation for different materials. So using the BIM or using the digital representation of the building, we will be able to do lots of simulation, lots of scenarios that we'll be able to come up with some sort of understanding about how the building is going to behave, how the building is going to perform, and how the different type of materials is going to make difference in terms of the carbon footprint of the building, in terms of energy consumption, etc. So there are a number of tools that we've developed in order to measure some of these sustainability agenda.
ماشي دكتور. طب بعدين حضرتك يا دكتور هل في عيوب للبيم؟ يعني لو احنا بنتكلم على السيستم بتاع البيم، ايه هو اكتر حاجه حضرتك شايف عيب فيه؟
Well, هو مو عيوب. It's just basically for the past 1192, we published a paper on this. It is the. I think there is a fairly big amount of effort needed to keep up with the forms, to keep up with the input of the information to be. So therefore, you could be. Credited, you need to keep all these the different forms in different ways. So that's a simplification is needed from both the software and the processes. And I think this will not achieve until there is a interest and there is some sort of indication that the technology really is changing. And it has a cost-effective impact on buildings. At the moment, whoever you talk to, they might give you different stories about why you're using it, what's the impact in terms of financial impact in the project of utilizing BIM.
حضرتك مع ان يبقى في كود للدوله ولا كل شركه تعمل كود خاص بيها؟
لا طبعا الكود وهذا it's a general understanding of how the industry should operate. So we have here in the UK what we call Construction Industry Council, which will be backed up by some government department because government is a client, is a big client, but we can't just let every company develop their own way of working. So we need to have a particular, like what we've done here in the UK, a particular standard that is based on years and years of research and development and implementation, and then that will
will get the credibility of the government through mandating for their projects. So for their projects, and that is, we set the ball rolling and the agenda for the rest of the big clients.
طب هو طب حاليا اعتقد ما فيش ولا دوله عربيه عامله اي كود, واعتقد حضرتك شغال في كود في قطر او في مشروع لعمل كود.
هو الكود الكود really we're trying to develop some standard processes.
تمام.
That will be then underpinned by technology. Technology is already available, but the processes are so we develop 9 different processes which is we are publishing at the moment, and it's these processes that needs to be embraced by project owners. So therefore, the rest of the supply chain, the contractors and designers, will follow. And these processes are netted and integrated under the umbrella of whole life cycle information flow and construction site. So or construction projects. So that's what we need really to embrace the. The way. So we at the moment we're looking for, as you know, through some form of industry formation. We call it BIM Qatar. So we have a number of industrial companies on board supporting the implementation of these. And at the moment, we're just trying to see which government department might like to house these areas.
ماشي دكتور. طب هل في مقارنه بين تكلفه تطبيق البيم من ناحيه التدريب والاجهزه والسوفت وير مقارنه مع العائد على الاستثمار؟
Yeah, I mean it's obviously particularly in the UK there are lots of studies and all available online in terms of the return on investment and there are a number of projects, real life projects, particularly I will refer to the Minister of Justice in the UK, who took on board implementation, early implementation of different passes. And there is a big study that has been published in terms of return on investment. There's lots of reports as well on the Manchester Library in terms of being used. And we have our own work as well in terms of the return on investment. Even in Qatar, we will publish a paper soon about return on investment in a couple of buildings that we'll be monitoring, but not on the crash detection part. But it is quite different from one project to another. But basically, the business case in Europe and the UK being made about the use of processes and technology. And this is there's no way back on this. It might in a few years' time it might appear in different shapes, as I said about the technology and about the way things are needs to be done. But really, all in all, companies are now equipped with the technology and the processes. So I don't think there's a way back in terms of throwing everything and just restart again. It's just because of the heavy investments companies have been making in terms of the tools, in terms of the people, the skills, the methods. And I'm sure in the Gulf, these will be realized sooner or later that the value is really quite substantial.
Particularly
when we move to facility management, we used to manage the facilities in a way that for 20, 30, 40 years, the return on investment would be even higher.
طب بالنسبة لموضوع المشاكل القانونية, يعني الموديل ملكيته ترجع لمين, للمالك ولا للصمم ولا يعني في بعض المشاكل القانونية حتى الآن في الدول العربية لسه متحلتش.
صحيح. You're right. I mean, here we say the model is belong to whoever is paid for it. So at this particular moment in time, clients are investing in so they can keep the model, so therefore they can use it post-construction. particularly for facility management and things like that. So all in all, I think the model belongs to the construction team. Construction team meaning not just the site operation, but beyond that, which is the way that the building is being built. But all in all, it would depend on the type of contract that is being embraced. For example, here we have the PFI, which is the where companies build and operate, so therefore the model will be belong to them. There are other types of contracts, which is like new engineering contracts, in which the contractor and the supply chain will finish their work once the client got hold of their assets. They got hold of the assets across all the models that associated with it, because they paid for it. At the end of the day, I think the client will be the owner.
تمام يا دكتور، انا شاكر جدا لحضرتك واسم بيم ارابيا، بشكر حضرتك على اللقاء الجميل دوت، وبشكر حضرتك على المشاركات الجميله في بيم ارابيا ودعم البيم في دولنا العربيه، وربنا يجزيك كل خير، والف شكر لحضرتك يا دكتور.
اهلا وسهلا. احنا وعدنا بيبر على تطبيقات البيم في العراق، فان شاء الله
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله، يا رب يا رب باذن الله
ان شاء الله. شكرا جزيلا.
الف شكر يا دكتور، الف شكر يا دكتور، جزاكم الله كل خير، الله يسلمك يا دكتور، شكرا. بالذات لما كنا البيم شغال مع جي اي اس في مشاريع الطرق او الريل، هل في مشاكل بتظهر؟
والله I don't have that much experience in using GIS in road in linear projects, but I think some of the issues are the it's incompatible. Some of these rabbit files, for example, being used with the way, for example, in which some of the systems that's going to be used in terms of GIS, for example. So still there is a work that's currently being done on the city GML, which is basically standard that we integrate all the assets on an urban scale. So still there is lots of work to be done on the standard. The problem, once they reach a particular point in the standard, then the software industry will move on. You know, that is the sort of issue that we have now. It's a catch-up.
تمام. طيب حضرتك شايف ايه هي الحاجه اللي هتبقى مايلستون او معلم كبير في البيم في المستقبل، يعني الحاجه اللي احنا نبدا نركز عليها بحيث ان احنا نبقى حاطين رجلينا على طريق البيم في المستقبل؟
I think probably a number of things that needs to happen. This is what we're doing here in the UK. It's not only to enable these very big companies, but the supply chain. If the supply chain is trained well and incorporated in the journey, then things will work a lot better. Because as you know, not much of these big contractors would do work, particularly around the world. They mostly depend on supply chain that will collaborate, and particularly small medium contractors that come on board and do the work. So basically this enabled, that's an important part of the construction industry, that this is what they've done in the manufacturing sector, which they enable these supply chain to collaborate and to come on board. This is one thing. So that means probably a new generation of software. At the moment, we are very much dependent on the lack of Autodesk and other companies, but it needs a little bit more cheaper, thinner, collaborative software that will be able to embrace this particular change. And I don't think things are happening in terms of the open source and other things that's happening. So probably these issues are quite crucial to get people to be engaged and to come on the problem journey.
تمام يا دكتور. طب حضرتك كنت كاتب بحث عن البيم مع الاستدامه والمدن المستدامه، ازاي البيم ممكن استفاد منه في تطبيق السستينابيلتي؟
Well, we've had a number of research projects looking at looking predominantly at using the outline processes, outline design processes, and
sort of beefed up or augmented with IT tools, they'll be able to predict and forecast the issues related with the probably building energy consumption, strategies for reducing energy, the use of different material sources, what we call here carbon footprint. We've got something called the Green Book, which is specifying some carbon footprint calculation for different materials. So using the BIM or using the digital representation of the building, we will be able to do lots of simulation, lots of scenarios that we will be able to come up with some sort of understanding about how the building is going to behave, how the building is going to perform, and how the different type of materials is going to make difference in terms of the carbon footprint of the building, in terms of energy consumption, etc. So there are a number of tools that we've developed in order to measure some of these sustainability agenda.
طب بعد اذن حضرتك يا دكتور، هل في عيوب للبيم؟ يعني لو احنا بنتكلم على السيستم بتاع البيم، ايه هو اكتر حاجه حضرتك شايفها عيب فيه؟
Well, هو مو عيوب. It's just basically for the past 1192, we published a paper on this. It is the I think there is a fairly big amount of effort needed to keep up with the forms, to keep up with the input of the information to be so therefore you could be credited. You need to keep all these the different forms in different ways. So that's a simplification is needed from both the software and the processes. And I think this will not achieve until there is interest and there is some sort of indication that the technology really is changing and it has a cost-effective impact on buildings. At the moment, whoever you talk to, they might give you different stories about why you're using it, what is the impact in terms of financial impact in the project of utilizing BIM.
طب عندي سؤال لحضرتك. حضرتك مع ان يبقى في كود للدولة ولا كل شركة تعمل كود خاص بيها؟
لا طبعا الكود وهذا it's a general understanding of how the industry should operate. So we have here in the UK what we call Construction Industry Council, which will be backed up by some government department, because the government is a client, is a big client. But we can't just let every company develop their own way of working. So we need to have a particular, like what we've done here in the UK, a particular standard that is based on years and years of research and development and implementation, and then that will get the credibility of the government through mandating for their projects. So for their projects, and that is, we set the ball rolling and the agenda for the rest of the big clients.
طب حاليا اعتقد ما فيش ولا دوله عربيه عامله اي كود، واعتقد حضرتك شغال في كود في قطر او في مشروع لعمل كود.
هو الكود الكود really we're trying to develop some standard processes.
تمام.
That will be then underpinned by technology. Technology is already available, but the processes are so we developed 9 different processes which is we are publishing at the moment, and it's these processes that needs to be embraced by project owners. So therefore, the rest of the supply chain, the contractors and designers will follow. And these processes are netted and integrated under the umbrella of whole lifecycle information flow and construction site. So, or construction projects. So that's what we need really to embrace the the way. So we at the moment we're looking for, as you know, through some form of industry formation. We call it BIM Qatar. So we have a number of industrial companies on board supporting the implementation of these. And at the moment, we're just trying to see which government department might like to house these areas.
ماشي يا دكتور. طب هل في مقارنة بين تكلفة تطبيق البيم من ناحية التدريب والأجهزة والسوفت وير مقارنة مع العائد على الاستثمار؟
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously, particularly in the UK, there are lots of studies and all available online in terms of the return on investment. And there are a number of projects, real-life projects, particularly I would refer to the Minister of Justice in the UK, who took on board implementation, early implementation of different passes. And there is a big study that's been published in terms of return on investment. There's lots of reports as well on the Manchester Library in terms of being used. And we have our own work as well in terms of the return on investment. Even in Qatar, we will publish a paper soon about return on investment in a couple of buildings that we'll be monitoring. But not on the crash detection part. But it is quite different from one project to another. But basically, the business case in Europe and the UK being made about the use of processes and technology, and this is there's no way back to on this. It might in a few years' time, it might appear in different shapes, as I said about the technology and about the way things are needs to be done. But really, all in all, companies are now equipped with the technology and the processes. So I don't think there is a way back in terms of throwing everything and just restart again. It's just because of the heavy investments companies have been making in terms of the tools, in terms of the people, the skills, the methods. And I'm sure in the Gulf, these will be realized sooner or later that the value is really quite substantial. Particularly when we move to facility management, we need to manage the facilities in a way that for 20, 30, 40 years, the return on investment will be even higher.
طب بالنسبة لموضوع المشاكل القانونية يعني الموديل ملكيته ترجع لمين للمالك ولا للصمم ولا يعني في بعض المشاكل القانونية حتى الآن في الدول العربية لسه متحلتش
صحيح you're right I mean here we say the model is belong to whoever is paid for it so at this particular moment in time clients are investing in so they can keep the model so therefore they can use it post construction particularly for facility management and things like that so all in all I think the model belong to the construction team meaning not just the site operation but beyond that which is the way that the building is being built but all in all it would depend on the type of contract that is being embraced for example here we have the PFI, which is the where companies build and operate, so therefore the model will be belong to them. There are other types of contracts, which is like new engineering contracts, in which the contractor and the supply chain will finish their work once the client got hold of their assets. They got hold of the assets across all the models that associated with it, because they paid for it. At the end of the day, I think
the client will be the owner. Thank you, Dr. I'm very grateful to you and BIM Arabia. بشكر حضرتك على اللقاء الجميل دوت وبشكر حضرتك على المشاركات الجميله في بيم ارابيا ودعم البيم في دولنا العربيه وربنا يجزيك كل خير والف شكر لحضرتك يا دكتور
اهلا وسهلا احنا وعدنا بيبر على التطبيقات البيم في العراق فان شاء الله ويل بي ببلشت
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. يا رب يا رب بإذن الله
إن شاء الله. شكرا جزيلا.
ألف شكرا دكتور. ألف شكرا دكتور. جزاكم الله كل خير. الله يسلمك دكتور. شكرا. تطبيق البيم من ناحية التدريب والأجهزة وسوفت وير مقارنة مع العائد على الاستثمار؟
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously, particularly in the UK, there are lots of studies and all available online in terms of the return on investment. And there are a number of projects, real life projects. Particularly, I will refer to the Minister of Justice in the UK, who took on board implementation, early implementation of different passes. And there is a big study that's been published in terms of return on investment. There's lots of reports as well on the Manchester Library in terms of being used. And we have our own work as well in terms of the return on investment. Even in Qatar, we will publish a paper soon about return on investment in a couple of buildings that we'll be monitoring. But not on the crash detection part. But it is quite different from one project to another. But basically, the business case in Europe and the UK has been made about the use of processes and technology. And this is there's no way back on this. It might in a few years' time. It might appear in different shapes, as I said, about the technology and about the way things are needs to be done. But really, all in all, companies are now equipped with the technology and the processes. So I don't think there is a way back in terms of throwing everything and just restart again. It's just because of the heavy investments companies have been making in terms of the tools, in terms of the people, the skills, the methods. And I'm sure in the Gulf, these will be realized sooner or later that the value is really quite substantial. Particularly when we move to facility management, we used to manage the facilities in a way that for 20, 30, 40 years, the return on investment will be even higher.
طب بالنسبة لموضوع المشاكل القانونية، يعني الموديل ملكيته ترجع لمين؟ للمالك ولا للصمم ولا يعني في بعض المشاكل القانونية حتى الآن في الدول العربية لسه متحلتش.
صحيح. You're right. I mean, here we say the model is belong to whoever is paid for it. So at this particular moment in time, clients are investing in so they can keep the model, so therefore they can use it post construction, particularly for facility management and things like that. So all in all, I think the model belong to the construction team. Construction team meaning not just the site operation, but beyond that, which is the way that the building is being built. But all in all, it would depend on the type of contract that is being embraced. For example, here we have the PFI, which is the where companies build and operate. So therefore, the model will belong to them. There are other type of contracts, which is like new engineering contracts, in which the contractor and the supply chain refuse their work once the client got hold of their assets. They got hold of the assets across all the models that associated with it because they paid for it. At the end of the day, I think the clients will be the owner.
تمام يا دكتور، انا شاكر جدا لحضرتك واسم بيم ارابيا. بشكر حضرتك على اللقاء الجميل دوت، وبشكر حضرتك على المشاركات الجميله في بيم ارابيا ودعم البيم في دولنا العربيه، وربنا يجزيك كل خير، والف شكر لحضرتك يا دكتور.
اهلا وسهلا. احنا وعدنا بيبر على التطبيقات البيم في العراق، فان شاء الله ببلشت.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. يا رب يا رب باذن الله
ان شاء الله. شكرا جزيلا.
الف شكر يا دكتور. الف شكر يا دكتور. جزاكم الله كل خير. الله يسلمك يا دكتور. شكرا.
Are investing in so they can keep the model, so therefore they can use it post construction, particularly for facility management and things like that. So all in all, I think the model belong to the construction team. Construction team meaning not just
the site operation, but beyond that, which is the way that the building is being built. But all in all, it would depend on the type of contract that, that is being embraced. For example, here we have the PFI, which is the where companies build and operate, so therefore the model will be belong to them. There are other types of contracts, which is like new engineering contracts, in which the contractor and the supply chain will finish their work once the client got hold of their assets. They got hold of the assets across all the models that are associated with it, because they paid for it. At the end of the day, I think the client will be the owner.
تمام يا دكتور، انا شاكر جدا لحضرتك واسم بيم ارابيا، بشكر حضرتك على اللقاء الجميل دوت، وبشكر حضرتك على المشاركات الجميله في بيم ارابيا ودعم البيم في دولنا العربيه، وربنا يجزيك كل خير، والف شكر لحضرتك يا دكتور.
اهلا وسهلا. احنا وعدنا بيبر على تطبيقات البيم في العراق، فان شاء الله
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله، يا رب يا رب باذن الله
ان شاء الله. شكرا جزيلا،
الف شكر يا دكتور، الف شكر يا دكتور، جزاكم الله كل خير، الله يسلمك يا دكتور، شكرا. تمام يا دكتور، انا شاكر جدا لحضرتك واسم بيم ارابيا، بشكر حضرتك على اللقاء الجميل دوت، وبشكر حضرتك على المشاركات الجميله في بيم ارابيا ودعم البيم في دولنا العربيه، وربنا يجزيك كل خير، والف شكر لحضرتك يا دكتور.
اهلا وسهلا. احنا وعدنا بيبر على تطبيقات البيم في العراق، فان شاء الله
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله، يا رب يا رب باذن الله
ان شاء الله. شكرا جزيلا،
الف شكر يا دكتور، الف شكر يا دكتور، جزاكم الله كل خير، الله يسلمك يا دكتور، شكرا. ما شاء الله ما شاء الله، يا رب يا رب باذن الله
ان شاء الله. شكرا جزيلا،
الف شكر يا دكتور، الف شكر يا دكتور، جزاكم الله كل خير، الله يسلمك يا دكتور، شكرا. جزاكم الله كل خير، الله يسلمك يا دكتور، شكرا.